Hello, welcome back to my channel. I'm doing this year's series on life experiences, things that I've experienced, things that I've learned, and about the only good things left for those things that I've learned is to share them. And that's what I've been doing. So this week we're going to talk about creating the life you want. Now, if you go over YouTube, you'll find lots and lots of people that talk about it in different videos in different ways, and I think this is a really good one, especially if you've gone on in life a bit like me and you're there going, is it really what I want? Have I got what I want yet? You see, we all want to be happy, and if we want to be happy, then we need to create the life that we want. Not that of what society tells us we should have. We don't just have to live that repetitive rut of go to work to get the money, to buy the food, to get the energy to go to work. We should always be able to do what we want in life. But we have to go out there and get it. Most of us work a busy 40-hour plus week, working in a dead-end job that we're not really interested in. The time off from work we spend with family, going on holidays, friends in the pub, because we just want to chill and forget about it. And then, of course, we've got the money that we've just got to keep paying those bills and maintaining the house to be done. And yes, it all has to be done. But is this busy? But is this busy and seemingly pointless life what we want? I've spoken before about finding purpose. You might argue that purpose to be able to enjoy life is enjoying it with family, doing what we want when we're not working. I would agree with that. But what about the work bit? The stress we carry from it when we're not there . Do we really want that? What about all the what ifs we carry because we don't have time or the confidence? Because of everything else that's going on. What do you think would happen if you made just one positive change in your life a year for the next 5 years? What do you think might happen if you found a new hobby? Something just for you. Something you've always wanted to try and discover. We start giving it maybe an hour every couple of weeks. What do you think would happen if you started spending 10 minutes a week looking at that business idea that you've always wanted to do? But where does this opportunity, where do we find these opportunities to create the life we want? Is it when we find the job? When we start the family? Or what about school? Each of the subjects we learn at that young age have an important significance behind them. For example, history is about learning the mistakes of the past to create a better future, not just for self, but for society. Some complain that we don't go back far enough, but what we understand is that history just keeps repeating itself. It just looks different every time. Maths is not just about numbers, it's about learning to make calculated choices. Kids complain that we should teach them how to do tax returns, but those are the things that constantly change. But the point behind the returns and the lessons of the subject remain the same. English language. It is just writing in a good way. It gives us the tools to sell ourselves for that perfect job, that perfect dream. Yet kids in school don't teach, complain that they don't get taught how to behave in an interview or in a job. But all jobs are different, and some haven't even been thought of yet. Chemistry is not just about mixing chemicals together, but preparing some to help in the basics of disarming war or fighting plagues. Biology is not just about learning about the human body, but the consequences of not being sensible in life. Religious studies is about learning diversity and respect for others who do believe in things that are different to our beliefs. PE is about learning the importance of being active physically, because it's linked to mental health. And the list goes on. But for us who have left school and plodding along in that rut, can we change? Can we still create the life we want? Or is it too late? Of course it's not too late. We just need to stop, take stock, and refocus. Stopping is about taking that moment out on a lunch break at work or on the journey home. Think about what you want your life to look like. What is the end product going to be? What is it that is truly going to make you happy? Things that this new life should not include. They should not include divorce or putting kids in adoption. But it might look like a new job or moving to a new area. It might mean you need to deal with past traumas properly, which might include seeking professional help. Never be ashamed to ask for help, because your past should never obstruct your present, and certainly should have no place in your future. To create the life you want, you need to stop making excuses. I'm too tired after work. I need to rest at work on my breaks. I have no time because I have kids. Everyone has the same 24 hours. Everyone works hard and is busy. Every parent has the same dilemmas. But how do you think those who have become successful in creating life, when they also worked a 40-hour a week job and had 3 kids while creating that life? They are people who just went out there and made it happen. And this is how you create the life you want. You go out there and you just make it happen. The best part about it, you get to do it your way. There are no rules. You create them. As long as you don't stop someone else getting what it is they want, it's an open road. So go out and create the life you want.